Thank you guys so much for joining me on our very last and final episode of Feel Good with Sophia Roe. Without further ado, we are going to make these delicious nut butter cereal bars, almost like an adult Rice Krispie treat. That's kind of what I'm going for here. We're gonna be featuring this spectacular product, LAKA. Think of it more like an adaptogenic nut butter. It's delicious, super fragrant, and most importantly, really, really, really easy to work with. Think of the same way that you used to make Rice Krispie treats as a kid. It's all right in one pot. So we are gonna take a tablespoon of coconut oil. Now, if you wanted to use vegan butter, that's perfectly fine. And we are also going to take 2 tablespoons of maple syrup. Now, keeping in mind, we are making a cereal bar. So a lot of the maple syrup part is gonna factor into how sweet your cereal is. If you're using cereal that's not sweetened, you might wanna add a few more teaspoons of maple syrup. We're also gonna use 1 teaspoon of vanilla. Feel free to use a whole vanilla bean if you want to, if you're fancy like that. Sometimes I'm fancy like that too. Now we are gonna take peanut butter. Now, if you wanna use almond butter, pumpkin seed butter, sunflower seed butter, if you can't do nuts and you wanna do seeds instead, fire. And this is 1/4 cup measure, but we're gonna use 1/2 cup. This is gonna get messy, but that's what we're here for. If you oil up your measuring cup beforehand, whatever you pour in is gonna slip right out. I mean, it's actually kind of like amazing. So if you get this spoon a little wet, it's gonna help get your peanut butter completely out of your situation, which I think is really great. Now, without further ado, we are gonna get our LAKA. So we're doing 2 tablespoons. This stuff stays pretty liquidy at room temperature. Because of that, you wanna make sure you refrigerate it after you open it. We're gonna come in here with some salt because we wanna season every step. There are so many different varieties now of cereal. It's really like the choice is yours. I'm gonna go with the Cheerios today just because I'm a Cheerio fan. But it really, it's up to you. Even if you wanted to do this with granola, that would totally work. We're gonna take 2.5 cups of this right in. This is a really big, just liquidy, fun, delicious mess at this point. So we're gonna take it directly to heat. You wanna make sure you keep this on super low because remember, we are not actually cooking anything, right? So you will start to see already when you first put this down, this sort of really beautiful drippy texture. At this point, the heat is off and we are super nice and saturated. This, I'd say, is about melted. So we're gonna take it off the heat. So we have just a little casserole dish and a piece of parchment paper, and I have some water. The reason I have some water is because we're getting our hands involved. And you're gonna grab this and it is so, so sticky. So this is where it's like so fun for a kid to like get in here and really get your hands involved. And then we're gonna take it directly to, these are hemp seeds. If you wanna do hemp seeds, chia seeds, if you wanna grind up some sesame seeds, it's really up to you. But you're just gonna roll this mixture in these hemp seeds and really saturate, really get it nice and coated. And then you're gonna take it and just let it rest. And we're gonna put these in the freezer and let them get nice and solid, which won't take long. I mean, listen, we're talking like 10 minutes in the freezer, like not long at all. These have to be stored in a cool, dry place or they will melt, they will come apart, because remember, like I said before, this product is made to be very liquidy at room temperature. And you need to store this in the refrigerator, so you also need to store these in the refrigerator. Into the freezer we go. All right, so these have been in the freezer for about 1/2 an hour. Nothing's gonna happen if you put them in the freezer for over an hour, even overnight. Once they set, they're holding their shape. It's no problems here. And we're gonna take a clean plate. I'm gonna plate these. Just a little hemp seed here. And we're just gonna stack these up. This would be actually a really great moment to take some cacao powder. Just kind of dust it lightly on top. Another thing that I think would be equally as delicious, some salt. So taking a little, think like an iced caramel type situation, which, and it's funny because the LAKA really has an interesting kind of caramel creamy texture to it that's really, really nice and gorgeous. Beautiful. And just take a bite.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God, so good.
The taste of it is, they're so nice and rich and dense, which is great. This also could be really great if you wanted to take some cayenne pepper or something. They could make it really complex and yummy. Ultimately, you could probably eat this stuff right out of the jar and it would be delicious. In fact, I have, and it was delicious. Thank you guys so, so, so much for watching. Hopefully, these female founders and getting to know them and their stories has been as inspiring for you as it has been for me. The idea of bio-individuality is showcasing itself more and more and more in the wellness space, and that's really special to me. All of these founders have completely different stories, have completely different backgrounds, and completely different dreams, and it's been such a joy to get to know them, all under the guise and the beautiful umbrella of wellness. So, thank you so much for watching, and I love you.